Hello 2022, great to see you guys again. This latest project of mine utilizes an old Academy STUG kit given to me by my former boss. I had to strip the old paint and redo everything including the missing parts. Using the old and new Tamiya figures, I modified the poses to tell of a story about two Wehrmacht soldiers who are close friends. Unfortunately, during a firefight, one friend was badly wounded on the right thigh and legs. The close friend is being comforted by an official or a fellow soldier. The backdrop is a damaged thug hit by an Allied tank destroyer, punching through the surgeon or armor skirt. I'm using our local paint stripper product to do the job. I would like to apologize as the number of scenes in this video are too grainy or have low resolution. My camera settings were not correct, as I'm still getting familiar with the camera. Again, this is a budget build and I wanted to create something from scraps. Seeing the bare plastic color of the kit, we can now work on the canvas. Luckily, I have two spare boxes of these Tamiya figure sets to work on. I used hornet heads to replace four Tamiya heads for added expressions. At this stage, I am now visualizing the diorama layout with the base. Using the cheap styrofoam as the terrain template, cutting it to the contours of the landscape. I wanted a compact diorama so as to save space. The size and shape suits me already. Now let's use wood glue. Cutting the Tamiya figures to enable me to modify their poses. Visualizing the layout with the elements placed. Using aluminum cutouts to add belts to the figures. And enhancing the creases and gaps of the uniform with a hot blade. Using the old trick to flatten the injected pin marks of the plastic with super glue and baby powder. Once dried, you can sand it down and smoothen the surface. Using the two-part putty and the trumpeter zimmerit tool, I apply the zimmerit on the specified surfaces of the stug. As the putty tend to stick to the grooves of the tool, I use baby powder to decrease the adhesion. I noticed the sherzin that came along with the kit was too thick for my taste, so I easily made one out from styrene just by cutting them using the old skirt. In order to replicate the damaged sherzin or skirt, I use a large diameter screw and use a candle to heat it and then melt away the styrene. This is the stage where I once again check the diorama layout with all its elements. This is still under visualization, where all the elements and pieces should have balance and a story is created. Checking the final layout before painting. Using the ambush camo pick on my cell phone as reference, I will attempt to replicate this. I used the same dark yellow for the scratches, then painted a layer of German gray mixed with hull red for scratch effect. I am using a local wood varnish treatment for the baseboard, and this one is called dark wood. I apply several coats and layers to make it solid. On top of my ground mix, I apply real earth soil to add volume and texture. I am a fan of AK Interactive Diorama products. Having a tight budget doesn't mean you don't spend on quality products. This foliage is really worth it. And thank you once again for reaching up to this point in the video. Like I said, thanks for watching and please subscribe.